Hello everyone, welcome back to our lecture series on course title Fluid Mechanics 2. This is our 12th lecture, and in this lecture we are going to solve some numerical which are based on our previous topic, drag on sphere, which we have discussed in last three lectures. So let's start with the first numerical. It is given that a ball of diameter 70 mm is supported in a vertical airstream which is flowing at a velocity of 6.5 meter per second. Calculate the weight of the ball. Take value of the density for the air as 1.25 kg per meter cube, and nu, that is kinematic viscosity, is given as 1.4 strokes. They have asked to calculate weight of the ball, and all the given data is viscosity, density of the air, diameter of the ball and velocity of the fluid flow, and they asked to find out weight of the ball. So first thing, we will just sum up with the given data. What they have given? They have given diameter as 0.07 meter, velocity 6.5 meter per second, density 1.25 kg per meter cube, kinematic viscosity of air, which is given in the form of Stokes. So we are going to convert it into meter square per second, just divide it with 10 to the power 4. So it will become 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now just look at the example, what they have given. They have given 70 mm diameter ball which is supported in vertical airstream. That means that there is a vertical airstream in which this ball has been supported. That means that whatever in that vertical stream, this ball has been supported, so it is remain at its position. That means that whatever the weight component of this ball, which is acting in downward direction, that will be counteracted by the drag force which is acting on this ball, which is having diameter 70 mm. Now as it is supported in the vertical airstream, that is mean that it will be stationary at this position. That means that whatever the vertical weight component acting in downward direction will become equal to the drag force which is acting in upward direction. So we are going to consider this case and we are going to compute the weight of the ball. Just before proceeding, as I told you previously, the first and foremost thing, if given data is appropriate, then calculate Reynolds number. So here it is, diameter of the ball is given, velocity of the flow is given, and viscosity is given. So we can easily calculate our Reynolds number, which is given by rho Vd upon mu, or Vd upon mu, that is the ratio of this viscosity upon density. So by putting all the values, my Reynolds number, value of the Reynolds number is 3250. That means that it is coming in between 1000 to 10 to the power 5, 1000 to 10,000 or 1000 to 10 to the power 5. That means that we are going to make use of value of CD directly. If the value of Reynolds number is coming as less than 0.2, in that case we are going to make use of Stokes' law. But here my value of Reynolds number is exceeding 1000 but less than 10 to the power 5, we are going to make use of value of coefficient of drag directly, that we have discussed during the drag on sphere. And in case of laminar flow, when my value of Reynolds number is in between 1000 to 10 to the power 5, at that time value of the CD is given as 0.5. so we are going to make use of this value and we are going to calculate the drag force. We are going to calculate the weight of the ball, and while calculating weight, we are going to equate or replace our weight component with the drag force. So just simply, we know that what is our drag equation? Equation for the drag force, CD multiplied by A multiplied by rho U square upon 2. Now as this drag replaces, drag force will be replaced with the W. So value of the W, after putting all the respected values of the CD as 0.5, pi by 4 D square, D is already given at 0.07 meter. Density of air 1.25, velocity is given 6.5 meter per second divided by 2, that is multiplied by half. So I will get the value of weight component as 0.0508 newton. So this is our answer. Let's move to the next numerical, which is given as a steel sphere of 4 mm diameter falls in a glycerin at a terminal velocity of 0.04 meter per second. Just keep in mind that what they have given, terminal velocity. Assume Stokes' law is applicable, that is CD is equal to 24 upon RE, which is applicable. Calculate dynamic viscosity of the glycerin, that is mu, drag force acting on the sphere, that is FD, and drag coefficient for the sphere, that is CD. We need to calculate those three. tech specific weight of the steel and glycerin as 75 kilonewton per meter cube and 12.5 kilonewton per meter cube. So they asked to calculate dynamic viscosity, drag force and drag coefficient for the spear. Just look at the given data. So you will get the solution. You will get the idea of the solution of this particular numerical. What they have given, steel spear of diameter 4 mm falls in a glycerin at terminal velocity. As they have given terminal velocity, as they have given, assume Stokes law is applicable, we are going to make use of equilibrium condition, that is given by W is equal to FD is equal to FB. So we are going to make use of it and we are going to calculate the dynamic viscosity of glycerin, drag force and drag coefficient, and we are going to calculate the those three parameter by using all these given data. So just first thing, just write down all the given data, what they have given: diameter of the spear, terminal velocity 0.04 meter per second, specific weight of the steel 75 kilonewton per meter cube, that is 75 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 newton per meter cube, specific weight 12.5 newton multiplied by 10 to the power 3 newton per meter cube. Now first thing, we are going to calculate dynamic viscosity. As we all know, terminal velocity is given by u is equal to d square upon 18 mu multiplied by weight of solid, weight density of the solid body minus weight density of the fluid. So if I want to write down it in the terms of viscosity, I can write down that equation as mu is equal to d square upon 18 u multiplied by ws minus wf. So by putting all the respected value in this equation, we will get the value for the mu as mu is equal to 1.388 newton second per meter square. You can also make a use of W is equal to FD multiply FB plus FD. By putting all those values, weight component and drag force component and FB, by putting all those values, you can also compute this value of mu. If you don't remember this equation, in that case you can make use of this equilibrium condition and you can solve this numerical simply. Let's move to the next. As they asked to calculate drag force, and we are make use of terminal terminal velocity equation, that is u is equal to d square upon 18 mu ws minus wf, which were based on the Stokes law. So we are going to check it for the Reynolds number. So we are going to calculate simply Reynolds number, which is given by rho ud upon mu, and here it is. My value of Reynolds number is coming as 0.147, which is less than 0.2. so whatever our assumption is holding good here, and our answer is okay. So next thing, we can calculate drag force by using Stokes law. The same 3 pi mu multiplied by ud. I just put all the values, you will get the value of the drag force, which is coming out as 0.00209. again, the last thing they asked to calculate, that is a drag coefficient. Again we are going to make use of Stokes law, that is given by cd is equal to 24 upon re. Just put the value of Reynolds number here, you will get the value of cd, which is coming out as 163.26. as it is dimensionless, no need to mention any dimension here. Hope you understood this. Let's move to the next numerical, where it is given a ball, a 2 mm diameter metallic ball of specific gravity 11 is allowed to fall in a fluid of a specific gravity 0.9 and viscosity 1.4 newton second per meter square. Determine drag force exerted by fluid on the ball, pressure drag and skin friction drag, and terminal velocity of the fluid, terminal velocity of the ball in the fluid. So we are going to calculate all those parameters. Again, same here, we are going to make use of terminal velocity equation and Stokes law, but obviously we are going to check it for the Reynolds number. The first and foremost thing, just write down all the given data, what they have given. Specific gravity of the metallic ball is given, but we need specific weight or weight density of the metallic ball, and just multiply it with 9.81, you will get the value of specific weight of the steel ball, that is 107.91 kilonewton per meter cube. Again, specific gravity of the fluid is given, multiply it with 9.81, you will get the value of specific weight as 8.83 kilonewton per meter cube. Again, they have given viscosity 1.4 newton second per meter square. Now we are going to solve this numerical one by one. First thing, they asked to calculate drag force. So for the calculation of drag force, we are going to make use of equilibrium condition, that is W is equal to FD plus FB, and we are going to calculate the FD in that equation. So our equilibrium condition is given as W is equal to drag force plus force of buoyancy. Now the first two forces we are going to calculate by using this relationship. W is equal to pi by 6 d cube, that is volume of the body, multiplied by weight density. Just put the respected values, you will get the value of a weight of the spear, and again a force of buoyancy, the similar way you can calculate. Just replace your weight density of the body with the weight density of the fluid, you will get the buoyant force which is exerted by the liquid on the ball. And just put all those values in this equation, you will get the value for the FD, that is coming out as 4.151 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4. Now we know that by using Stokes' law you can calculate pressure drag and skin friction drag. So for the pressure drag, it is given by one third of the total drag, and for the skin drag it is given as two third of the total drag. So skin friction drag, which is two third of the total drag, which is coming out as 2.767 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4, and pressure drag, which is one third of total drag, and by putting this value of total drag, your value is coming out as 1.384 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now the last thing, what they asked to calculate, terminal velocity, which you can calculate by using again Stokes' law, which is given by FD is equal to 3 pi mu upon UD, 3 pi mu UD. By using this equation you can compute the terminal velocity. Just put all the respected values here, you will get the value of this U. As we have used Stokes' law, again we are going to check it for the Reynolds number, whether it is correct or not. So we are going to calculate Reynolds number again, rho UD upon mu, density of the specific gravity of the fluid is given. So density of the fluid will be coming out as 900 kg per meter cube. U is we have just calculated U here, 0.0157. again diameter, which is also given, viscosity also given. Just put all the respected values, you will get the value of Reynolds number at 0.02, which is less than 0.2. so our answer and use of the Stokes' law is valid and our answer is correct. Here it is the end of the solution. Hope you understood those three numericals, and just go through some other numericals for the practice, so you will get better idea. If you have any question, you can ask it. Thank you for watching.